Hi, I'm Kelsey Brennan-Wessels, and in today's special edition of Earth from Space, we're looking back to the launch of the Vega rocket from Europe's spaceport in the French Guiana in early May. Vega carried three satellites into orbit, including ESA's PROBA-V mission, which is designed to map land cover and vegetation growth across the entire planet. Here to tell us more about the Vega launcher is Stefano Bianchi, who is the manager of ESA's Vega program. Welcome to the show, Stefano.
Thank you.
And we also have in the studio today the PROBA-V mission manager, Bianca Hirsch, who will tell us more about the satellite. Thank you also for being here today.
Thank you.
Now, first off, I'd like to just say congratulations to both of you on a successful launch. And to Stefano, this is the second launch of Europe's newest launcher. What makes Vega so unique?
Vega is the new European launch vehicle. We call it small, but in fact it's 30 meters tall and more than 130 tons of propellant. And it makes unique because its aim is to carry small satellites, and the European Space Agency and Europe has a lot of the small satellites. So we had the first flight, the maiden flight, on the 13th of February last year. And the mission was a great success because it was basically a flawless flight after exploitation of all data. We couldn't find any major issue to change the design of a launcher after a maiden flight, and this is quite a big result for Europe to have such a maiden flight result.
Great. Now, of course, this is the second flight for Vega, and it put not only PROBA-V into orbit, but another two satellites, I think from Estonia and Vietnam. How is it possible that one rocket can put three different satellites into three different orbits?
It is a smart rocket, of course.
Sounds like it.
So, it is a smart rocket, and in fact, the main objective of this second flight was to qualify, let's say, the capability for multiple payloads. So for this reason, we have a multiple payload adapter. So in fact, the first payload proba, the main payload was hosted on the top of this multiple payload adapter. And the Vietnamese satellite and the small Estonian satellite, which was the first Estonian satellite ever launched, were inside this multiple payload adapter. So in the second flight, we tested this capability, and we tested also a new flight software and some new feature for, let's say, demonstrating the adaptability of Vega to the market. And so we had also some thrill because we had a postponement of the launch. So we had the window was a 0 second window, so we had to launch exactly at that time. And at the first attempt, we had some strong wind in altitude that due to safety reasons, so we had to postpone by a few days. And by a few days, we managed to have again a wonderful launch without any issues. So the payload are transmitting correctly and they are on the right orbit. So again, it was this time really a historical success, because I think that it never happened in certainly it never happened in Europe, but I think that it happens maybe once in rocket history to have the first two flights of an entire new launch system so successful.
Go so smoothly, absolutely. Now, after the rocket put the three satellites into orbit, what happens to it? Does it fall back down?
The third feature we tested in this launch was with the orbitation. So we have a code of conduct, let's say, to not pollute space. So we adopt univocally this code of conduct. So we deorbit the last stage. In this case, the last stage is a small liquid propulsion stage called ABUM. And basically, after releasing the last satellite, which is the Estonian satellite, we had an additional firing of the ABUM engine to the orbit. So the ABUM falls in the Pacific Ocean, far away from Brazil and Chile coast.
So Bianca, after almost immediately after separation from Vega, the PROBA-V satellite started to undergo different tests and checks, of course some of them related to its separation from Vega to test the altitude, if it's pointing in the right direction. What is the current status of PROBA-V?
The current status is that the satellite is in its commissioning phase. This means we're checking out the satellite and also the payloads on board. almost a week after we launched, we have taken the first image with the main payload, the Végétation instrument, and that was on the 15th of May, and we've taken an image just off the coast of France. And the image quality is very good with that, what we can see right now in terms of radiometry and also geometry. And every day since then, we're basically taking few images, we're looking at them, checking the image quality.
Great. And when do you foresee the beginning of the satellite's operational phase?
If everything goes according to plan, and this is what it does right now, it all looks pretty good, then we will have the satellite operational around early November.
Great. Now, of course, the satellite's primary payload is designed to map vegetation growth and land cover. And this is going to happen across the globe every 2 days. Is that correct?
Yes. That is correct.
Okay.
Yes.
And what can this be used for?
First of all, we're looking at how the state of the vegetation is, and then of course we're also looking at what is the development of that vegetation throughout the year. For example, to do crop monitoring, we can see if there's an imminent failure on crop forecasts, on harvest statistics, and we can also give advice then to respective entities who can take countermeasures. We can also look beyond that, looking at, for example, the steady growth of deserts or at deforestation. But also, since we're mapping the whole landmass, we can also look at, for example, inland waters.
Wonderful. Okay. Well, Stefano and Bianca, thank you so much for being here today. We look forward to the third launch of Vega, and of course, we look forward to seeing what Proba V can see. And to our viewers, thank you so much for watching. And remember, to find out more about space and about our planet, you can visit our website at www.esa.int. From the ESA Web TV studios, I'm Kelsey Brennan-Wessels.